Hey, welcome to another episode. My name's Jared. This is Aaron. We're with Tier 1 Concealed. Today we're going to play with some Ballistic Dummy Labs dummies. That's where they make these out of gel, but they give you all the internal bones and organs and everything to give you some realistic testing and data on different projectiles. So that's what we're going to do. I will say that I failed Ballistic Dummy Labs, and it's my fault completely because I don't know what the exact shelf life is on these, but I think you want to use them within 2 weeks to a month or so of getting them, and we're like on month six. So these were sitting in a shop and they didn't do very well. So I don't know if they use any type of a food-based product in the gel to make it deteriorate. This poor guy lost his head. We're gonna try to preserve this and we'll just do a separate head test. So I'm gonna go ahead and just chop this guy's head off. I never thought I'd be doing anything like this, but now I kind of have an idea.
How does it feel?
What it feels like to be a surgeon or maybe a member of ISIS.
Durka Durka, Muhammad Jihad.
I'm sorry, buddy.
Clean cut.
So these all had heads on them at one point, and it was falling off. So this one's preserved fairly well compared to the others, except for the head splitting and coming off.
Come check out this one.
Whereas this guy must have caught a popular virus going around or something like that.
Coronavirus!
Because obviously you can see it's destroying his lungs and whatnot. So
what could it be?
This is the zombie dummy. And so what we're gonna do with these two first is we're gonna shoot this first guy, but we're gonna test and see what rounds may over-penetrate, see if we can get anything to come through and hit this other one. Might be kind of hard for us to see any damage with how much damage is here, but we're gonna do our best and work with what we have. So we'll start from like a 22 caliber and kind of make our way through. We'll run some full metal jacket.
Full metal jacket.
Just to see what that does, as well as some popular defense rounds. So let's check it out. Let's check it out. Okay, so the first gun we're gonna use, CZ-457. We're running 22 subs out of this. So it's basically as light as we can go. And yeah, this one's a 457 in a Manner stock, running a Steiner optic with a spur mount. So let's see how this does. Dead air can. So we'll try and send this one through his upper chest. I'm gonna crouch down a little bit to line these guys up. I don't suspect any over penetration, but you never know. So we'll take it maybe just to the right of his sternum. All right, easy enough. Let's go check out the damage. So you can see the entrance right here. I was trying to take it just to the right of his ribs.
Oh, I was like, holy shit.
A hex exit wound?
So
it didn't get very far at all.
Yeah, so back here on the back of the dummy, I literally don't see any.
I think I can see it actually.
Anything.
You look up, it like bounced off the rib and went up probably like maybe 2 inches. There's just a little black spot.
That might not be it, but you can see right here the channel going in between the ribs.
Maybe survivable. Who knows? I still wouldn't want to find out. Because that's close to his heart, so it could have his heart. We're not seeing any obvious internal bleeding here yet.
Do you want to send another one and we'll? I don't know.
Could shoot it like right here.
Maybe hit
to
it.
See like the actual.
Yeah,
penetration.
Try not to hit a bone.
All right.
Somewhere.
So we'll do another one and we'll send it down here in his lower left abdomen area. All right. So his lower left abdomen. All right, let's see the damage. All right, so it looks it looks like it actually deflected.
Yeah, that went through.
Yeah, it barely grazed his intestines, and you can see the path of the bullet was changing. Probably just past it, maybe down low here.
Yep.
Because I'm not seeing anything on this guy, which would be hard to see anyway. But yeah, you can see how it kind of shredded that gel. The other thing that we don't know on this, because we let this gel age, is if it's going to react quite the same as a fresh gel. So that could play a factor in it. But we'll do do what we can with what we got. Okay, so pretty minimal damage with the 22. It was subsonic, so even more underpowered on there. So now we're gonna see what a full metal jacket 9mm round will do. Where should we shoot this guy? Anybody have any good good places?
Just like where an A-zone would be to go right in the center sternum.
So hit center sternum. All right, we'll transcend it just above that little pre-drilled hole. Okay, let's do this. 9mm, here we go. So we went just above that hole. Looks like we shattered his sternum. Is there anything going on in the back? Surprisingly, no. So come check out the back here. So there is nothing going on. So that was a pretty direct hit, like obviously hitting bone. And then he's also got his spine in line with that. Surprising. So those are 115 grain full metal jackets. Not seeing any bleeding going on in there yet. So maybe he's out of blood. Okay, so surprisingly enough, full metal jacket, we didn't get any over penetration. I'm sure if we hit in a different area that would be a possibility. But now we're gonna shoot a spear gold dot plus P. It's a 124 grain plus P. So and I think this time I'm gonna take it just over here, maybe try and hit him in the heart. We'll see if we can cause a little bit more damage. Heart shot. Sure, maybe it's some piss poor shooting. That was piss poor shooting. Yanked that over, so pretty close to the same impact. But let's check the back. Oh, that's cool. That'd ruin his day. So you can see the projectile lodged in his spine, just on the left side. So almost all the way through, but not quite, which is good. That's what you'd want out of a defensive round. So hit hard, did some damage, and then stopped. Could have also cleared more of a pathway for it since I hit so close to the previous entrance wound.
It kind of looks like the full metal jacket bullet.
It wasn't there before.
Wonder if it bounced it off. I'm kidding.
Oh, that does.
It does look like the full metal. Should we? Well, I guess we'll do an autopsy later.
Please. Yeah, we'll have to dig that out. So
that's interesting.
It could have because it was, that definitely wasn't there before. All right, so now we're gonna try 10mm, and we only have FMJ because 10mm is impossible to find. So we're gonna do it with what we got. What do you think about this lung?
We can do that.
Try that.
And 10mm is one that's typically an over penetrator, which is why they went to 40. So it'll be interesting to see what this actually does.
Great shot.
I think that went through.
It kind of looked like it did.
Oh yeah.
So right here, broke a rib, cracked a rib. We even got blood this time. Great
hit
job.
A rib in the back too. Through.
Yeah.
It did go through.
Let's get the camera in here.
Redirected.
So yeah, broke a rear rib, passed through. Looks like it redirected and probably just missed our guy back here. So it definitely did pass all the way through. Unfortunately, we missed the guy in the back, which means you don't have an additional lawsuit on your hands.
Yeah,
oh, hey, he saw we did get the second guy.
Oh, we did?
All right, so the beauty of having a high-speed camera is that we can see things. So it looks like
it
clipped him right in his armpit right there. So not as much deviation as we would have thought. Okay, so our friend here is getting shot up pretty good. The 10mm definitely passed all the way through, broke a few ribs.
Today, Junior!
And now we're gonna try Miles Concealed Carry. These are hollow points.
Yeah.
Okay, so jacket at hollow point, 50 AE. And I don't know, maybe try and hit him up high. Oh my gosh. Damn. Screw getting shot with that.
Definitely went through both of them. Or into the second.
So Miles is 2 for 2 on ribs. He's just like,
holy,
a ladder, just cracking them.
See right there.
And
oh my gosh.
The round's in there?
Yeah. The projectile's stuck in the second one.
Let's come check out the exit wound here. So definitely went through his lung, destroyed a bunch of bone and tissue. Kept on going right here. And is there an entrance? Do we know?
Somewhere in this area.
So, oh, there's a jacket or something from another round sitting in there.
You can see the slug right there.
All right, so come over here. I don't know if you can film in here. I'm guessing that bullet entered in somewhere right here, but it is lodged right behind his ribs.
And then look at this mark. There's a big piece of the jacket right there.
Okay, so a 50 is probably not ideal for concealed carry. Unless it is like these zombie looking dummies, unless it's a zombie apocalypse, then you get more for your money. Take down two guys at once. So very impressive, very impressive. And that was a hollow point, so, but not enough to stop it. All right, on to our next caliber. Okay, so we're gonna move into rifles and we're gonna run a 62 grain green tip 223. So penetrates some armors and stuff like that. We'll see how it does. I expect it to zip clean through both of these.
Good?
Yep.
All right, we'll take it through his upper chest. All right, no dot.
Oh, geez. So you can definitely see the difference that velocity of the round makes. So yeah, that did some damage on the exit wound. And as far as this guy goes, I fully expect it to have hit him.
We don't see anything back here.
And there's no visible exit wound, but
it's so hard to see an entrance wound here. No damage to bones or anything.
Oh yeah, there is some. That must have been where the 50 hit.
Yeah, that ribs all cracked.
It looked like it was like here-ish.
Oh wait, yeah, right here.
See, you can see the,
it's right behind his rib.
Something ricocheted and went off into the distance.
Okay, so that bullet, it turns out, is so it entered in here.
You can see the jacket right there.
And
the
it part just
of the core
stopped just behind his ribs. So over penetration, which is what we expected. Okay, so we tried the green tip. Now we're gonna try just a standard 55 grain full metal jacket. Okay, 55 FMJ. Try and send it like right under his sternum. Okay, we're clear. Entrance wound right there. Got some organ damage going on. And it looks like we super jacked up his
spine. Yeah, it looks
spine.
Like the spine really caught good. It.
Vertebrae's moving.
So, guessing with the velocity of this round that it was pretty destructive inside with the hydrostatic shock. And then it looks like it shattered his vertebrae.
Spinal.
He has scoliosis though. So if he didn't, it could have been out of the way. I don't know, it's tough. 77 grain boat tail haul point, my favorite for shooting 223 at distance. We're gonna shoot this guy in like the lower abdomen. So I'm gonna take a knee, if I can see if I can get through to the other guy. All right. His digestive tract is not gonna work the same. I can say that. Okay. Oh, so let's review the exit wound here. So that's part of his backbone sticking out, and that's not good, medically speaking. So definitely will rip through right there. And
what?
There's some jacket right there.
That's been there the whole time.
Oh, that has?
Sawyer. That's been there since like the
look,
second shot.
There's a tiny piece right there.
Oh yeah.
All right.
And down there, there's like.
So lots of bone and fragment coming out here. There is like a little piece of jacket right there. we're gonna have to review the high speed footage to really see if and where this guy got hit. All right, so after reviewing the high-speed footage, I think when it passed through here, it changed direction slightly and actually just grazed the top of this plate that it's sitting on and didn't really do much other than pass underneath it. But if his body was there, he would probably be upset. This is like a feel-good slow-mo shot.
Go ahead.
All right, now we're gonna move into bolt guns. This is an Accuracy International AX chambered in 6 millimeter Creedmoor. These rounds are going about 3,000 feet per second. We're gonna run Hornady's ELD match, so that's the AMAX round. So let's check out what this does.
His lower left rib cage.
All right, we can obviously see where that impacted, and you can see a lot of destruction with it dumping all of that energy in, even from the front. And then here from the back, we can see it ripped through his ribs.
So I guess that's about 50 cents a rib, huh?
And I have zero clue. We sent some wire, probably used to hold his ribs together in this one. Can't really tell. Gonna rely on the high speed footage. He's doing pretty well, considering, you know, if you think about it.
Yeah, just wrong place, wrong time kind of guy.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a 50-50. Like, he may survive some of these and maybe some he didn't, but there's nothing that's like, well, I can't remember now.
Yeah, obviously a lot of this, but on high speed, there were some bigger chunks of bone and or jacket or something that hit this area, but it looked like it broke apart pretty damn good before it even came out the back of the first
one. So it has that AMAX tip on it. It's gonna come off. It probably just destroyed the jacket and everything, but as it was passing through. So pretty good.
Yeah,
pretty good.
It's like what we always say, it's a numbers game. You're either gonna make it or you're not.
yeah exactly.
So I'm gonna shoot it with my Accuracy International AT in 6.5 Creedmoor. That's got a 24 inch barrel doing about 2700 FPS with a 140 grain bullet. So I'm gonna try and hit him like right here. All right.
Holy crap. There's lots of chunks. All right, so I clipped him.
Got stuff all over here. Turn and film that, my
back. Oh, is that like a piece of tissue?
Big old solid chunk of flesh over here. He's 25 yards away.
So come take a look at this.
Absolutely.
So we got lots of bone just sitting in here. Obviously a big chunk of his tissue. So you don't want to get hit by a bolt gun. Ugh.
Be knocking so gnarly. This all over bystanders.
Relatively decent damage. You know, we're shooting from about 10 yards away. It doesn't look fun either way, but now we're gonna step it up just a notch. We're gonna send a 750 grain Hornady AMAX 50 cal through this. And we're gonna try and just center punch him in the chest right here, really line up with that guy behind and just see if we can actually get some really good damage. All right, going hot.
Yeah.
I'd say the second. Why did the second guy do worse?
So we can't confirm that it penetrated.
Oh,
we have
shit,
to watch the slow mo.
Okay, right here.
Holy crap. Oh, did you go like high sternum right there?
Yeah. That's exactly where I was going.
Wow. And then back here, that's you could fit a small puppy in this wound channel. I mean, not that you ever would.
So these are kind of like sponges that hold all the fluid. So we're gonna have to get some fresh ones and do some other testing.
Let's see if we can roll this guy over, at least.
No, that's a lot of damage.
So these are, they have like a, I don't know what I'm talking about here, but I think that they're like a full metal jacket. They've got some other type of a steel core, maybe something like that on there. So that's why I suspect it zipped through the first guy so good. Maybe it dumped some energy or changed the flight path of that bullet.
It probably hit him sideways.
Yeah, we might be able to see it on the high speed. But I will say that the damage on the second guy, you definitely don't want to be the second guy. So now we got the body stuff out of the way. Body stuff. Anyway, so now we are going to shoot the head, and we're going to have Sawyer run in 6.5 Creedmoor because that seemed on video to have the most hydrostatic shock or that energy dump. So he's going to send around through Larry's head, and we're going to see if he survives. I think he'll be fine. All right.
Hold on one second. Ready, Miles? Yeah.
Oh, there's pieces of skull flying.
Safe to say that dumps a lot of energy and removed his skull and brain from his head. Yum. Yum.
Oh! Oh my gosh.
My gosh.
For a split second, it looks like the aliens from Mars Attacks.
You do not want to get. Oh, well, maybe that's
like sucked.
That guy was like Pearly Gates. Okay, so for the next head that we have, we're going to use the 50. I don't know that it's going to do much because on the other footage, it just zipped right through the first body. And these are like anti-material rounds, so they're not really going to perform like a Botel hollow point. But you know what? It's a 50, and we want to see.
Pain. A little gnarlier than the first one.
Dude,
look at this.
It went right through the hat. That's exactly what I was trying to split his brim.
Oh my god. Look at all that blood.
Dude, killer shot.
Oh, oh my gosh.
There's so much blood. Let's
dude, look at the hat right here where he hit it.
We gotta keep that hat.
Here we go. Here's his top job.
Whoa!
He almost split the brim.
Yeah, that hit exactly where you were aiming almost. So I tried to make sure I didn't hit anything low because it would have just passed right through. I wanted it to hit like right in his forehead. That probably caused enough deformation hitting the front of the skull, right? To dump some energy, because before when we shot the body, that almost had no resistance. Just zipped right through.
Really? Yeah.
Damn.
Man, guns are dangerous. Like you don't wanna.
This dude is not okay.
Have an accident.
This is the craziest shit. A piece of his skull right there.
Probably a piece of his skull in the next
county. There's a piece right there.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. This has been really fun for us, actually, and we're hoping to do a lot more stuff like this. Obviously, guns can be pretty destructive if used carelessly. So you have this pile of carnage here. We're going to clean this all up, and there's just parts of him everywhere. I'm not sure what that part is, but anyway, obviously he's all over the place, but be sure to like and subscribe, hit that notification bell, and let us know in the comments what we should do next. Thanks.